shot as we stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring.
Merry Christmas, Signal Mountain, and welcome to the year's final episode of Sup Signal.
The presents are wrapped, Thomas's Yule log is finally ready, and we're all excited for that magical time of the year.
But first, we go to Austin Sawyer to tell you all you need to know about next semester's Sadie Hawkins Winter Formal.
That's right, ladies, Sadie Hawkins.
Oh, hey, man. Bro, what's up? Hey, how you doing, man?
Great.
Hey, have you heard about the Sadie Hawkins dance on January 31st from 9 to 11?
No, but I'll be waiting for someone to ask me. It's getting pretty close to 9. She's not here yet. Oh, yeah? I had a dream too, that someone would go to the dance with me.
Hard to be sure.
This is so real.
Sometimes I feel so insecure.
These morning announcements, no one's going to the dance with me.
Sadie Hawkins dance in my khaki pants. There's nothing better. Oh, oh, oh. The girls ask the guys.
Although we're well past November, our bearded champion still has not been recognized.
Congratulations to Micajah Tucker, who edged out Harrison, Sean, and Jimmy to take home the gold.
I had a chance to speak with MC Delta T on what it means to win.
Jingle bells ring, snowing and blowing up bushels of fun.
Hey guys, I'm here with Micajah Tucker, and today we're going to talk about what it takes to win. Now, Micajah has joined the ranks of the ancient Romans, the Alabama Crimson Tide, and many other famous winners in our time. Micajah, what do you have to say about that?
Well, it's great just to be part of that elite fraternity, and if I was still applying for colleges, totally be top of my resume, Signal Mountain Beard Off Champion. So, Honors College, it's going to be on there.
Awesome, thanks. Back to the studio.
Several different students have had the honor of being Signal Mountain Student of the Month. However, there has always been one person to congratulate them on their achievements and have offered a pie in the face. For December, Student of the Month, the award goes to Morph Man.
Go.
Hi, we're Students of the Month, and we want payback.
All right, I'm here with Student of the Month, Morph Man. So how does it feel to be Student of the Month? Okay, how many people have you pied in the face? 3, okay, that's good.
Oh my gosh, Brad.
The annual Hoops for Hope tournament is this Saturday. Here's some of the team members with all the deets.
Hey guys, make sure that you come out tomorrow for the Hoops for Hope tournament. The girls play at 3:30 and the boys play at 5. They're playing South Pittsburgh, so come out. That'll be a good game. It costs $5 to get in, but if you wear your t-shirt, you get it for free. Thanks.
Well, hey guys, I'm Mr. Barbo, the new technology teacher here down in the middle school. And I'm going to tell you guys about an awesome opportunity for everybody in middle school. So this is all you 6th graders, 7th graders, and 8th graders. What we have tomorrow is what we call the Hour of Code. And we want you to do is go on, you're going to register with me or someone in school. You're going to start coding computer technology stuff. You'll go and register. You actually get to create your own codes online with computer programming. It's a really cool opportunity. If you have any questions, ask me. I'm here down the 6th grade hallway, and I'd love to tell you more about it. Thanks, guys.
Anybody can learn. We want to get 10 million students to do the Hour of Code.
Hour of Code.
Hour of Code.
The Hour of Code.
Hour of Code.
Hour of Code.
Before exams began, students got the opportunity to dress up in their favorite holiday attire to celebrate the season.
We saw elves, snowmen, reindeer, and some very, very ugly sweaters.
Here are some of the best looks.
Candy apple red with a ski for a wheel. And when Santa hits the gas,
We may not be able to walk a mile in someone else's shoes, but we can get a glimpse of life through their eyes. Here's a very unique life in a day.
Someone left this delicious cake half eaten on my desk. Brian here is going to put an elk head on Napoleon's body. And he has my blessing. This is me being natural. I will show you what to do.
How are we doing it the other way?
I don't know. We don't question the system.
It's the same thing now.
We don't question the system.
The system's wrong.
This is some art that my 4.5-year-old son Zeffy made. There's some soup. He likes to make soup. There's our garbage can. Painted by Zeffy. These are our dogs Buttercup and Rosie. I like to speak to them in an Irish accent. It's good for them. There we are, girls. Cece. There we go, girls. Time to put away the clean dishes. Hey, Zeffy, what are we going to go do?
Tree hunt.
Let's go get a Christmas tree right now. Come on.
No, thank you.
Before it gets dark.
Here.
Then Santa's gonna know and you will get coal in your stocking.
Alright!
Middle school students can look forward to tonight's holiday dance at the school at 6 o'clock.
High schoolers, you have just over a month until your dance. Ladies, have fun asking someone out.
Well, I guess that's it, guys. Christmas break is almost here and we won't be back until next semester.
It's been a fantastic 16 weeks. Although we've had some late nights, it's all been worth it. I'm sure 2014 will be even better.
On behalf of the Sup Signal crew, I'd like to thank everyone who's helped out throughout the year, especially you, the viewer, who tuned in every week as we cataloged the year.
Finally, here's a recap of the year's best moments.
Until next year, I'm Marie Whitmire.
And I'm Grant Hensley, wishing you a Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year.
Everybody knows.